Go big or go bold could be the philosophy behind the Bucks' efforts to nail down a naming rights deal.
For Peter Fagan and the Bucks, it's not just about finding a local deal. The deal has no borders. So whose name will grace the new arena? It's a multi-million dollar question.
You can break it right here.
I wish I could break it. Yeah, great.
This is a process that has taken a lot of time. I'm sure you would have wanted the deal done now. Give me your thoughts, your vision of behind the naming rights.
Well, I think number one is like we're not going to compromise. We think there's a tremendous value. Mm-hmm. We want an unbelievable brand association with this building because it's such a special project. And you know, the Giannis effect is a big deal. It's kind of exploded for us on an international basis. So all of a sudden, the prospects of who to work with have changed over the last 6 months.
You sound very bullish with this. You're saying we're not going to compromise. But with any deal, there's compromise. What are some of the things you're looking for in a company to have that name on that arena?
Well, it's all the company you keep, right? So we're looking for 1 and 1 equals 2. So how can we align with a brand that almost strengthens our brand equity, a great blue chip international brand in a perfect world, increases our audience, you know, as well, has a great following. I mean, if it was a consumer products company, you know, how do we leverage kind of what they've done in the marketplace? If it's a technology company, how can we leverage, you know, their tech insurance company? How can we get their buyer groups like engaged in our business? So there are lots of different alignments.
So let's put a name on the table because it's been out there, Foxconn. Is that a deal that you thought you were going to be able to close?
I think in some shape or form we'll have a partnership with Foxconn. At this point, I wouldn't think it's probably going to be naming rights.
Okay, because you were very involved and I saw you at all the events of the Foxconn announcements. And so it looked like, but give me a sense of why the footprint here for you isn't just Milwaukee, why you're looking beyond just the legacy companies here.
Yeah, so I think the biggest news is just the metrics. So 90% of our impressions go outside our home state.
What do you mean by that?
Yeah,
so I mean, like when we do our digital, when we do our broadcasts, when we do TNT, our ESPN, our Fox, our highlights, all those, more than 50% of them are going to China.
Why is
really?
And you know, China. To tell you what the audience growth is. Mm-hmm. So we've got this international presence that has exploded like way beyond.
Unique to Milwaukee, or that's the NBA?
It's the NBA trend, but certainly unique to Milwaukee in the last 2 to 3 years. And Giannis has a big deal with that when you think about 10 to 20 million video views from outside the country.
So is it realistic? You're looking 7 to 10 million a year?
We're looking for a long-term 20-year deal in that range of $7 to $10 million.
That would make it one of the biggest in the NBA, wouldn't it?
It would put you like in a healthy position. You know, I think they're bigger and they're smaller.
What's the benefit that the company has to having that naming right for the 20-year lease that you want?
Well, it's the association. So like to be aligned with an NBA team in today's world is an opportunity like none other. It's the only league that has hockey stick growth, that broadcasts in 215 countries around the world, that has unbelievable alignment with other brands, and is really very special. So if you get the right company and brand that understands what the possibilities of association is and marketing is, it's a home run.
So, well, you've already kind of detoured us from Foxconn possibly being getting the naming rights, but are you close with any other businesses that are interested in putting their name on that arena?
We're dating. Yes.
You're dating.
I don't think
courting?
We're not engaged yet,
not
but
engaged.
We're dating. So, yes. Very seriously dating.
Well, that's good to know that.
Yes.
Give me a sense, though, when you look at the other, you've got other partnerships here. You've partnered with Harley Davidson. You've partnered with
BMO.
How important are the partnerships to the future?
Well, they're literally deemed founding partnerships. So they're crucial to where it is. Freighter, the Medical College of Wisconsin, Miller Coors, we'll have Coke in the new building. I mean, these are all foundational partners that literally by association build the equity of where our brand is. And we're big partnership folks. So we look to leverage their marketing prowess, like in the marketplace. Mm-hmm. I mean, Freighter, it's a great example where we've put millions of dollars back into the community and back into work development. So all these partnerships.
With a practice facility, right?
Right.
And that was part of the partnership. So looking forward to getting those naming rights and hearing what the next step is on that. But there's another big story to follow as well. There is no doubt star power makes up this young team.
Next on 414, Peter Fagan talks about building a winning team.